All right, forget the beaches and the theme parks. A one-of-a-kind experience is in the works on the Space Coast.
Watch 2's Scott Heidler got an exclusive look behind the scenes at a balloon that will take people like you and me to the edge of space.
Imagine lifting off for a trip into space at 12 miles an hour and with a glass of wine in your hand.
So I think when most people think about space flight, they think about high Gs and floating around and discomfort, and you're in a small capsule. At least a lot of people do.
Spaceship Neptune, a vastly different craft, soon to be taking humans to the edge of space.
For us, it's this incredibly gentle flight. If you can get on a commercial airline, you can get on this. We have a bar on board. There's a loo. It's a space lounge.
The space tourist startup set up shop on its own campus next to the Titusville Airport.
It is the center of where human spaceflight history was forged. It's an incredible place to have in our backyard. There's amazing employment base here.
Space Perspective now has 130 employees. Once it gets closer to taking passengers on the first flights late next year, they'll need to scale up. Both capsules and balloons are manufactured here. The balloon's made in a 700-foot-long custom facility.
As it goes up through the atmosphere, it expands. And so by the time it's at altitude, it's filled out the entire balloon. And now the balloon, instead of being long and skinny, is more or less round. And it's actually the size of a small football stadium. Mm.
Test flights with a Neptune replica start this year. Once passengers start to fly, they'll arrive a day or two before the trip. That'll start by boarding the company's vessel, MS Voyager.
Imagine it's really dark out, it's really awesome, beautiful stars. You'll get into Spaceship Neptune right on the deck of the ship. Then it will be released from the deck as the balloon then lifts the entire capsule incredibly gently up to space.
The trip up, about 2 hours.
Then you'll have roughly 2 hours in space to look over Florida, our incredibly beautiful Earth, over the Keys, over the Bahamas. Then you'll start a very gradual and slow descent. Takes you about another 2 hours to come back down.
Then splash down, the capsule picked up out of the water and placed back on the ship. Launch and splash down only about 50 miles apart. This after traveling about 20 miles up.
With tickets costing more than $100,000, the passengers will come from an elite slice of the market. But the company looks to expand that over time. Once they fly more flights and build more balloons, they look to open it to a larger customer base.
Certainly over time, we anticipate bringing the price down. Now, the truth is that the market is so vibrant that it's probably going to take us a little while.
Almost 1,200 tickets already sold, nearly half of those complete capsule buyouts. With big windows, the largest windows ever flown to space.
From the apogee of the flight, you're going to be able to see roughly 450 miles in each direction.
The craft and balloon have redundant safety measures, including 4 parachutes.
What's exciting is that the balloon technology itself has been flown thousands of times. And in the last couple of decades, there hasn't been a single in-flight failure with one of these kinds of balloons.
While Florida is Space Perspective's home, the company is looking to take it on the road down the line so others can see their slice of the world in a new light from space.
It really puts it into perspective, seeing something you recognize, which is also why we want to be able to fly from different parts of the world.
On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, WESH 2 News.